Well, hello everybody. So, Lisa De Nicolaes, writer for a year, and today we are going to discuss websites. And websites are so stressful that we cannot do it without the help of our dear Ronald the Clown. But websites are a very serious topic, and it's hard to know where to start. So, as mentioned, I've been a magazine designer for many, many years, and Ronald's foot is digging my shoulder. No, maybe that's worse. Okay. And because of that, I am a designer. But website design is something very different. And back in the day, I would design a website in InDesign and then hand it off to some hardy person fluent in code, and they would make it happen. And it was that way, you know, doing websites was fine. But then I needed to create my own website. So, you know, I looked around for various things, decided that I gave WordPress a try, seemed unfathomable. At that point, WordPress was mainly a blog, you know, you put your blogs on it, and it seemed really organized. You know, we'd file them by date and have this awesome filing system, but it didn't seem intuitive, and I'm a Mac user as opposed to a PC user, and I think that makes a big difference. I think if you lean towards PCs, you will find WordPress very easy to get along with. If you lean towards Macs, you will not. That was my experience anyway. So, tested the waters with WordPress and ran away in horror. Discovered a templated website, which they've always been around. I mean, Apple had one in the beginning. I did a small website on that. And that's the thing as well, is that my picture's jumping around. Sorry, distraction. That's the thing with websites. It's so easy to get distracted because they're just so awful to work with. Is that they have a fashion, you know, there's different programs out there. Currently, there's Squarespace, Wix, Homestead, which is what I use. And then there's all kinds of servers, you know, the service providers like GoDaddy. You can build websites on GoDaddy. So the thing is this, if you started out, you know, like 10 years ago when I did and abandoned WordPress, got one of these templated sites and built what was at that time quite an adequate site and utilized it more as a scrapbook. Linking back to my previous post about reviews, it was more like everything that was reviewed about the book or anything that was said about the book or emails that came in. It was a way of gathering all the positive feedback about the books and putting it in a central place. Now, websites have changed dramatically because people's attention spans have changed dramatically. Now, you have 6 seconds. That's it. No one is going to, you know, click through various things and read things. It's just not the way it goes. I've maintained that website, which is Lisa De Nicolaes Write, Lisa De Nicolaes Writer. I'd better check that out. Anyway, I'll post that at the end. You'd think I'd remember that. And I've maintained it up to now, The Occult Persuasion, which is book number 9. But the site is increasingly cumbersome to work on. It's an old template, it's very bulky. So I have subsequently taken out additional websites, templates with Homestead. They're fairly easy at first glance to use if you're a Mac user. They seem more Mac user inclined, although they perform better from a PC platform. So bear that in mind as well. And they are extremely clumsy and frustrating. So I recently decided that I was going to move my Minerva Reader from this templated website onto WordPress, and I was going to create a new author web page on using WordPress, Lisa Writer. That's what it's going to be. My name is just so long. But anyway, so full of confidence, I set off, I sign up for the thing, I do some courses on lynda.com, and I start trying to work out WordPress. It's so horrible. So horrible. So I'm now going back to Homestead. And again, I'm going to post some slides from the various things to show you. And again, it relates back to my previous post about compromising the quality of such things. Because, excuse me, you can have a fantastic website if you pay for it. Or, you know, if you have the time to dedicate to learning how to do that. I want to be writing books. That's what I really want to be doing. I don't want to be learning what WordPress. Oh, I think I have to go and get some. Yes, hang on. Well, apologies for that. Obviously, talking about a website was so stressful that it made me have a coughing fit. Now, you can see I've changed location, and you may see a tiny little, oh, she's gone. Oh, no, there she's back. Black head. That is Benny Ethel, the new cat. I'm hoping that maybe she'll get used to my voice. So that's why I changed location. But anyway, back to the website thing. The compromise of quality, you have, I mean, I know it's a terrible thing to say. Who can even say that I'm prepared to compromise quality? But either it's expense or I become a web designer. So I'm not prepared to do that because I want to write the 48. There's a lot of writing to be done. So I'm going to stick with my templated website, even for the Minerva Reader, because for me, it's more important to be reading those books, reviewing those books, and writing my own books than it is designing websites. And so I'm going to just, you know, bite the bullet. Maybe one day if I, you know, win the lottery or something, I'll get, oh, did she come back? No, she didn't come back. I'll get a fabulous website designed. But I hope this has been helpful for you, because the thing is, I think the best thing is to just try and do whatever is the easiest route for you. And remember, at the end of the day, it's the creativity that counts. I mean, I know an excellent product, you know, is a mark of excellence. And I do feel a bit chagrined that, you know, I wish I didn't have a better calling card to go out there into the world with. Keep hoping the cat will come back. But anyway, that's my view on creating websites. Homestead is the one I go with. I mean, the other thing with WordPress is then I tried to link my email. They started asking me for server ID numbers. And I was just like, oh my goodness, I want to just crawl under the bed where I think the cat has gone. Anyway, I hope this has been helpful. And if you have any questions about, you know, websites or the things I've done or mentioned here, you can just give me a shout. And this is Lisa DeNicolets, writer for a year, going to try and find the new cat, Benny Ethel Birdstar. Thank you. Bye. So now we'll take a look at the websites. This is Homestead. And I have realized through all my investigations, actually, as one does with most things, that I have a level of gratitude to Homestead. I know I curse them a lot, but the thing is, I'm not exactly known for my patience when it comes to technology, even when I'm working on the most speedy Mac that can have just about every program running at the same time. In fact, our IT manager, Tyrone, says, Lisa, a little patience would go a long way. Anyway, I'm working on that, Tyrone. Anyway, so the thing with this site, and here's some examples of it, is that the font comes in as this tiny thing, and then the box doesn't really like move around very well. So you have to zoom way out. And then if you have a lot of text in a box, it doesn't let you like click in the center of that box, wherever it clicks at the top, and then you have to try and scroll your way through it. Well, as you scroll, the box moves from time to time, and that's annoying because then you have to reset it. I've also found that you cannot work with multiple text boxes as you would do in InDesign or other programs. The only way to really handle this is to have one chunky text box that runs in a long stream, which isn't optimal either. However, as I say, having now had a look at WordPress, which was just so horrifying, I'm pretty grateful for this site. And if you look at the Lisa DeNicolets writer, I shouldn't struggle to remember my own website name, but anyway, you can see it looks a lot more antiquated, even with the interface and the tools. So hopefully now what I'm going to do is use Homestead to create an entirely new site, which will be called Lisa Writer. And while it won't have all the bells and whistles of WordPress, I think it will be a step up from the Minerva Reader and definitely a step up from lisawriter.com. So I guess at the end of the day, I'm saying thank you to Homestead, and we will forge on from here. Thank you.